Let's get into Russ and his conversation that he's been having publicly in a manner that we haven't really heard from him about his level of protection and needing that upgraded and his desire to still be with you and in Seattle. How would you rate your relationship with Russell Wilson as you and I are talking right here in the middle of May? Pete Carroll.
Yeah, well, it seems like it's really old news to talk about this because it's been such a long time. Rich, the little bit that he said carried so much airtime that it became bigger than life. Throughout the whole process, Russell, we've always been connected. We've always been talking. We've never not been in communication, and we weren't at all at this time either. And a couple things that came out got magnified. And the questions came out, and there was a couple things. You know, he was frustrated when he was talking, just like any of us can sometimes emphasize something that's, you know, on the top of our mind, and it can be played differently than it really played itself out. We've had a really good off season of working, and there was an ongoing media discussion that I did not take part in. John and I did not. We refused to be party to that. And Russ did what he could once he saw it happening to stay as quiet as he could because it was going to play and have a life of its own anyway. So what it amounted to was, I think, a refocusing, you know, making sure that we were on the same page, making sure that we were clear so that we could withstand any of the scrutiny that would come towards us. And we did that. And so we've had a good off season, and we're cranking. He's fired up and about his team. He's fired up about his coaching staff. He's fired up about the season coming up. And he, just as he knows how to do, he's been competing his butt off to be right and ready and be on point. So it's gone very well, even though that discussion lasted so long. And you had certain guys that just decided to keep the story going, and they just wanted to keep feeding it. And it really was much bigger than it was for us internally. And I thought we handled it really well.
Well, the reason why I bring it up, I guess, with you now is you and I had not spoken since then. And that was such a conversation.
My bad.
Then.
Okay. My bad.
No. I'm just, no, but I understand. It's just like, okay, I thought you did that, you know, that page had been turned, but the book is still open in terms of a national conversation with just quarterbacks.
It shouldn't be.
Well,
it shouldn't be. In terms of up here in Seattle, it shouldn't be. But I get it that guys are doing it, and I know Aaron's been real vocal, and whatever's going on there, it keeps this discussion alive. And so, you know, it's fun for the media, and they do what they got to do with it, and it's okay.
Well, you do bring up where I guess I was going next with Aaron in Wisconsin and the concept of, you know, hey, a quarterback should have a say in who's on the roster, and certainly about the way an offense is run. And how much is Russell involved in all of that with you and the rest of the staff? Now there's a new offensive coordinator in Shane Waldron being brought in right now. How much is that, if you're willing to pull back the curtain on, that he is involved in that conversation, Pete Carroll?
Yeah, well, Rich, first let me say, in a real general sense, you're either competing or you're not. And that means that if there's information that you can have and you have access to and it can help you make choices and decisions that you make, I've always been talking to players. There's been guys over the years, I've had them in my office or I've called them on the phone or now we do our texting. You know, there's something that comes up. They've got information. They've got special knowledge. I've never hesitated to do that. Russ, having been here for 10 years now, he's been around us a long time, and he's got a good perspective, as does Bobby Wagner. And we're fortunate to have Dwayne Brown. And guys, they have opinions that I don't have to act on the information, but I want to access the information. I'm okay with that, you know. So I've always been talking to guys. So how much does he have now? He doesn't have any more than he's ever had. I've respected the heck out of Russ for all of the reasons that he has proven he's worthy. And so when I get a chance to get something from him that can help me out, I'm going to him. I don't hesitate to do that. And I'll do it with any of our guys. Doug Baldwin was a guy. Richard Sherman was guys. I would talk to those guys about scheme, personnel, situations, times, social issues. I mean, you name it, you know. And that's the kind of program that we have run around here. So I don't think it should be overplayed, and I don't think it should be misstated either. Russ has a lot of good information, and so I go to him when I think it's appropriate, and he'll bring ideas at times to me just to try them out. We have that kind of relationship where it's okay to do that, but I'm not closing it off to anybody. And I can't tell you how much I talked to Bobby Wagner because he's been around here 10 years too. You know, and those guys have something to they have great insights. And so that's just competing to me. You know, it's no difference.
Hey, you watched all the way to the end. Thanks for that. Watch more right here.